Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. In the earlier sessions, we had looked into the arithmetic operators, the relational or comparison operators, the bitwise operators, the assignment operators, the logical operators. In this session, let's look into two other operators that are the membership operators and identity operators. So firstly, let's cover the membership operator. What are membership operators? Membership operators are used to check if a value or variable is present in a sequence or not. It basically checks if a particular value is present in a sequence. A sequence in this case can be a string, a list, a tuple, a set, or a dictionary. So it basically checks if a value is present in a string, or a list, or a tuple, or a set, or a dictionary. Based on it, it returns a Boolean value true or false. There are two membership operators in Python. They are the in and not in. What does in do? In checks if the value is present in the sequence. If it is present, it returns a Boolean value true. Else, it returns a Boolean value false. What does the not in operator do, membership operator do? The not in operator checks if the value is not present in the sequence. If it is not present in the sequence, it returns a Boolean value true. If it is present in the sequence, then it returns a Boolean value false. So it is just the opposite of in. In and not in are just the opposites. So now let's look into some examples how it works in Python. So suppose my string st1 is having the value I like coding in Python. So now I'll check Python in st1. Here in is the membership operator. So let us work it out in the practical sessions. So my st1 is equal to I like coding in Python. And now let me print Python in st1. Here in is the membership operator. It checks if Python is present in st1 string. If it is present, it returns the Boolean value true. So if I run that code, I get the Boolean value true, saying that Python is present in st1. Now let me take the same string st1, I like coding in Python, and let me print Java. Let me print Java in st1. Here again, it searches if the string Java is present in st1. Since Java is not present in st1, it returns the Boolean value false. So basically it returns a true or a false. Here string is nothing but a sequence. Instead of a string, we can use a list, a tuple, a set, or a dictionary. So now let's look into one more example taking list into consideration. So let me take lst1 equal to apple, banana, orange. So this is my LST1, and I want to search if apple is present in LST1. So I say print apple in LST1. Since apple is present in LST1, when we run the code, it returns a Boolean value true. Now let me say print grapes in LST1. So now if I run the code, we get the value false because grapes is not present in LST1. So the in membership operators returns a Boolean value which is equal to false. So now let's cover the not in membership operator. the not in membership operator. So here let me take the same string st1. I like coding in Python, and let me print Python not in st1. Since Python is present in st1, it returns a boolean value false when I run the code, telling that Python is present in st1. So not in returns true if it is not in the string, and returns false if it is present in the string. Now let's see one more example. Print Java not in st1. Since Java is not present in st1, it returns the boolean value true. So this is how the not in works in Python. We had taken the string example. Now let's check with the list example. Print pineapple not in lst1. Since pineapple is not in lst1, it returns the value true. So it returned the value true. Now if I say print apple in lst1, it returns the value false because not in lst1. It returns the value false because apple is present in lst1. When it checks for not in, it returns the value false because apples are present in lst1. So this is how the not in membership operator works in Python. Now let's look into the identity operators. Identity operators are used to compare the objects to check if they occupy the same memory location. If they point to the same memory location, then we say they are identical. They're identical. That is, the identity operator. There are two types of identity operator. It is the is and is not. So let's see the is operator. Is operator returns true if the two variables point the same object in the same present in the same memory location. If it is present in the same memory location, it returns the boolean value true, else it returns the boolean value false. Is not is just the opposite of is. It returns true if the two variables are not present at the same memory location, else it returns a boolean value false. So here my x and y variable are pointing to the same object 50 present in this particular memory location. With x is also pointing to this memory location, y is also pointing to this memory location. So the is in identity operator, how does it work in this scenario? If I say x is y, x is operator y, it returns true because it is present in the same memory location. Now if I consider another variable z, which is pointing to a different memory location, so if I say x is z, then it returns a boolean value false. So let's check in Jupyter notebook. So if I identity operator is, so now if I take two variables x equal to y equal to 10, and if I say x is the identity operator, x is y, then it returns a boolean value true since x and y are both pointing to the same object which is present at the same memory location. Now if I say my z equal to 20, it is pointing at a different memory location. Now if I say x is z, then it returns a boolean value equal to false, telling that they both are at two different memory location. Now let's look into the identity operator. Is not so here if I say x is not y, then it returns false because it is at the same memory location. If I say x is z, is not z, then it returns true because they both are at different memory location. So this is how the identity operator works in Python. So hope so friends, this is clear for you. The membership operator, that is in and not in, and the identity operator, that is and is not. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me in the comment section. If you like my video, please click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my future videos. Till then, see you. Bye bye.